Moon. That was a long one. Who am I? That must be the question I've been looking for. I wish I could save right here. Who am I? Well, we're near this thing. In case I lose it. Oh, what's this? Is this what we're looking for? Sudan terminal epistolary connection. Terminal number 905. Date of last cartridge load, July 1st, 2058. Quite a long time ago. I wish to communicate, good sir. Here you'll find the answer to your question. Who am I? Oh, cool. That's right, Inhibish. Who am I is the question that leads to the secret of your past. You are but a step away from unraveling the mystery, from the ancient mystifying events whose meaning I never did grasp till the end of my days. Perhaps only you are destined to reveal their divine plan. I promised you a key to the chest that store your parents' belongings. The key is before you, and with it I pass to you that which I had guarded in my memory for many years. Imagine if someone just came along and, like, knocked this thing over, ripped it out of the ground. Maybe stumbling out of here, for days, nights on end. Yes, the things in the chest belong to Zambul and Sarne. However, these people are not your parents or even your relatives. They had a son of their own once, but he had died in that explosion under the dome. He was 5 years old, and his name was Chagatai. Several days after the explosion, a golden eagle arrived here, carrying a human infant. Was it the... was it the one that we... the eagle that... goes outside? He set the child down on the ground in front of the yurt. You were that infant, Inhibish. Who you are and where you came from, I do not know. I hear stuff out of my left speaker. Hoping it's not one of those things. Oh, there's like a letter in there, like a postage envelope as well. Like a postal envelope. From that day, the home of my late son became a haven for you and Angus. I was not repulsed by the strange appearance of your bodies. Who am I to pass judgment on Providence? Dismay came a month later when Chagatai's features on your face became unmistakable. Goodbye forever, your Grandfather Bachin. What? I promise you a key. I'm a copy of their son? And I'm not human. Or he wasn't human, and I'm human. Because you're repulsed by the strange appearance of your bodies. He died. He was 5 years old. So they recovered him. It looks like, and put him in my body. He died in that explosion. That was the kid that exploded. Huh. I know I'm gonna take it. Search the chest. Empty envelope. Why is there an empty envelope? So half the people around are artificial or something, or more than half. I'm human. I'm guessing. The chests. These chests? It's very heavy. I need to remove the stuff that's inside to move it. Everything magazine. Which magazines cause sparks. What's this? Don't need it. Looks like a saddle. Oh, an old TV. Anything else in there? There's something else in there. Can I jump up here? I can. What's this? What's it? An old transistor radio. Don't need that either. I'm knocking that chair all over the freaking place. Now I can move the chest! Alas, the chest is still in the way. This thing is too big for this place. Kids' cowboy boots. These are the little kids' things. Toy rocket ship. Oh, I took that. That was him, the little baby. Packs of letters. One correspondent mentions Mark and Ida. I'm Ida's son? What? I've already written you about him. He works nearby at the station. Well, a few years back he'd met a girl. He says they saw each other only once in a company of friends, and somehow the way she looked at him, he's been dreaming of that moment ever since. Mark speaks of some strange sensation called the Babylonian effect, and that the entire institute is studying it at the present. Dezambul and I laugh in return. The sensation is totally normal, Mark. We've studied it thoroughly long ago. Smiley face. Kick your science to the curb and go to Ida before she gets her body replaced. So that's just all that. Look at these things hanging. What is this? I don't need that, whatever it is. It looks cool. Oh, what it is. Oh, a kid's typewriter. I see. Or hyperletter? I don't suppose I can open this. that was bothering me like that. I found something else, I guess. I'm your son.
I found it. You and Mark had met once before.
Yes, I already know. I remembered it.
Mark was recalling some kind of special moment.
Nothing so special that it stayed with me. Except maybe there was this strange sensation.
A sensation?
Yes. Sometimes I get a peculiar feeling. It somehow resembles anxiety, but only partially. I can't really describe it. It is a sad, pleasant feeling. I had felt it again that particular evening, and...
So, like, attraction, love, puppy love?
And what?
Anubish, I'm about to shut down.
No!
Wait. We're not done figuring out your past.
And we won't. I am out of time. I received a message.
What?
From whom?
From my neurochip. Only... the neurochip writes in red letters. I'm being informed that it is self-destructing.
Oh, man.
Know what I can do?
What?
Split myself in two.
What?
What do you mean?
When I shut down, my upper half will split from my legs.
Why?
I've no clue. That's just how my body works. I can show you. Watch.
Wait, don't. Ida, listen.
I'm listening.
Maybe there's still a way to fix everything.
Fix everything? Well, there is a way. If you can travel to the past and pass 4 digits to Professor Koch, that would fix everything.
That's how you say that? 4 digits. 3513. The beginning of the game, with all the stuff I was reading.
Fix. Everything.
It's raining. Ida's neurocopy is destroyed. You can bring Ida to her senses by aiming an electrical charge at the nerve plexus on her back. Take Ida to a powerful source of electricity. One of those shock with electricity to speak for a few minutes. Ah. Okay. Is that a good idea in the pouring rain? Oh. Well, electricity. I saw lightning. I guess I'm going back there. I think either that or these places. But I can't interact. I don't think it's there. I'm just gonna run. You know what? No, I'm gonna take this. Oh, God. What? Yeah, I definitely see that. Oh. Oh. So where am I supposed to go in here? Secure Ida in a vertical position at the center of the ruined flower bed. In here? Ruined flower bed. In here or out there? Because isn't there a couple... If I position her correctly, I'll be able to plug that sparking cable into her. Oh, those frickin' things. In here? I don't think so. Do we have sticks? Why do I keep forgetting to take sticks from home? Ah. Crap. It's actually kind of, I don't know. It's not scary, it's just jarring. It's very noisy, and I can't hardly move. Ruined flower bed. Alright, let me grab her. I don't know. Like, which one's the ruined flower bed? I don't see one of those things. But I probably wouldn't be able to hear it. I'm stuck in this. Come on. Let me out. Oh, crap. How do I know which one's a ruined flower bed? Oh, here. Let me up. How do I do it? This? Damn, the music is crazy. How do I bring her to a vertical position? Wait, what's it say? I have no need for this. Oh, crap. I need a stick. Oh. Trying to find a stick over here. It's very hard in the dark. Okay. Oh, the bird. That's who... I'm looking for the thing. I don't see it right now, so I'm gonna hold on to that. Can you help me? I can secure Ida here. Now, where'd I put her? I lost her. The thing was sparking, like, not there, though. It was somewhere else. I'm gonna grab this. I'm looking for her. It's so damn noisy. One of these things could probably... creep up on me. Where is it? What is my major malfunction over here? I got completely turned around. Sorry, guys. I had to go off looking for a stick. Chill. It's over here, isn't it? Is this where I left her? It stinks I couldn't add her to inventory. Where the hell? Okay, I'm ready to just find her and get the thing. How am I not seeing it? I know it's not up here. Here? Oh god, it was right here, right? She's here? Please tell me she's right here somewhere. Got her. Jeez. Alright, let me out. Reanimate Ida with an electric cable, which is back there behind us. I know, chill. I can just carry this? I guess this won't hurt me. Oh! Was that supposed to happen? Is that supposed to be happening? Where am I now? I supposed to attach her to the thing first? Can't use it. Can I... maybe... come here! I can't... alright. So how do I do it without doing it? One question. Can I use this? I don't know. Oh. I think I just can't do it when the... I think I just have to time it when the lightning hits. Oh. Grab it. I can't... oh, good God. I don't have it anymore? Oh. Other way? Around this way? In the back? Oh! Damn branches! I'm clicking. Can't hold on to it. What? In the back? In the back. I'm trying to plug it into the front. It says the back. All right, let me move. Let me guess. Let me look at it first. Here. Oh, I have to take that off. Okay. Now, if it doesn't kill me. Or knock me out or whatever. Oh. Okay. Don't succeed. Try again. Finally. In real life, I'd be dead, except, I don't know, maybe I am an artificial person. There's the shock. You're my mother! Yeah, are you there?
Are you there?
Ida. I'm here.
How do you feel?
Strange.
Strange? In what way? Describe your state.
I feel anxious.
That's good.
Good?
Yeah, good?
Yes. Just don't shut down. Look at me.
Why?
I'll explain everything later.
I will? Why is it good she's anxious? Did I have it right? Unless he's supposed to be Mark. I had it figured that he was our son. 5-year-old son. Sphere. That's the code. That's Mark.
Leave the crowd.
So guys, apparently Inhibish is Mark. And the way she's feeling kind of anxious is because she's nervous because she loves him, but I don't know. I kind of thought it would be their kid. The 5-year-old kid. The 5-year-old kid who explodes. Or is telepathy being used to communicate? So Anubis realizes that he's Mark. And he put in the code. Or Ida put in the code, either one. So the kid, Chagatai, is replaced by Inhibish. So was Chagatai a clone of Mark? And was Inhibish a clone of Mark? Not their kid after all. Because he said that Anubis's face looked just like Chagatai's. But what about Mark? So by putting the code in the past, Dr. Koch, I was saying Koch or Cock or whatever. I'm gonna go with Koch. They stopped the plague. Somehow sent the code into the past because he said, if only I had that code. And that's in the yurt in the beginning of the game where I read all that stuff. If only I had a simple 4-digit code, all of this could have been prevented. I think it could have been explained a little better. And the way he said he'd explain everything. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. Anyway. I don't know. I'm thinking, and I'm sure this is the kind of game that you might be able to pick up even more in a second playthrough. I'm thinking. Or at very least to go through everything in the yurt again, read all the stuff again. Now knowing what you know. Very interesting. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Hope it wasn't too boring. Minecraft cube things. Just think, all that I left in, I took out a lot of failures. A lot of failures. Probably like 5 or 6 altogether from all the 4 puzzles put together. And a lot of wandering around. There's a lot of wandering around you can do away from the lake. And, I mean, the only place you really need to go, the only place you need to go wandering the countryside is to look at those signs. To go sun, moon, sun, moon, sun, moon, but then you're following those. There's really no need to go past the lake. There's no need to check out all those little towers. I mean, I don't know if there's anything else to be found in the game. I mean, I probably missed a few papers lying by rocks and stuff like that. I came across those purely by accident for the most part. Just, oh, what's that, you know? So other than that, yeah, you're mostly running back and forth between really 3 different places. And then the flowers is kind of near the dome, the carnival. And the fruit is by the lake. and that's really it. Everything else just takes place in those other little areas, the three other areas we've been to. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you. Hope to see you in another Let's Play. I really enjoyed this game. And though I had its parts where I didn't know what the hell to do. But I want to thank you again so much for watching. And endure. In enduring, grow strong, and always seek adventure.